Some members of the media use their platforms to push their own personal bias and agenda to control exactly what people think.
And this is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
Go to work, get married, have children, act normal, walk on the pavement, watch TV, obey the law, save your old age. Then repeat after me, I am free. Slavery, it works better when you don't tell them. It's all a mind game. William Casey, CIA director, will know when our disinformation program is complete when everything the American public believes is false. They don't call it television programming for nothing. What if all you ever knew was a lie? What we call stupid equals asleep. What we call asleep is hypnotized, and what we call hypnotized is unconscious. We have been systematically put into a state of unconsciousness so that we cannot see what we are part of and what we are experiencing, though that is changing and changing fast. Until you make the unconscious conscious, it will direct your life and you will call it fate. All the time, the subconscious, which we're not aware of, is dictating the behavior and responses of the conscious. And if we don't understand the unconscious, then the conscious will just be a pawn in a game. It doesn't understand. Go to work, get married, have children, act normal, walk on the pavement, watch TV, obey the law, save your old age, then repeat after me, I am free. And we keep having to say we're free. And in America, they keep having to tell the people they're free every 5 minutes because they might otherwise suss that they're not. Slavery was never abolished. It was only extended to include everyone. And yet people go so out of their way to convince themselves they're not in a state of slavery. First stage of disconnecting from slavery, realize you're in a state of slavery. Then you know what to disconnect from. Leonardo da Vinci, there are three classes of people: those who see when they are shown, those who do not see. And this system we call life is designed, again from cradle to grave, to make sure as many people do not see. And that's what I call the perception deception. These are three major CIA people. William Casey, CIA director, will know when our disinformation program is complete when everything the American public believes is false. The CIA owns everyone of any significance in the major media. William Coley, CIA director. Deception is a state of mind and the mind of the state. James Angleton, infamous CIA operative. It's all a mind game. They don't call it television programming for nothing. It tells you what to wear, what to eat, what to think, what to love, what to fear, who to ridicule, who to condemn. One of the saddest lessons of history is this: if we've been bamboozled long enough, we tend to reject any evidence of the bamboozle. We're no longer interested in finding out the truth. It's simply too painful to acknowledge, even to ourselves, that we've been taken. Once you give a charlatan power over you, you almost never get it back. Almost never. But we're freaking going to. But that's what it is. It's a bamboozle. It's a mind program. This is a cognitive dissonance. This is a definition of it. Sometimes people hold a core belief that is very strong. When they are presented with evidence that works against that belief, the new evidence cannot be accepted. It would create a feeling that is extremely uncomfortable called cognitive dissonance. And because it is so important to protect the core belief, they will rationalize, ignore, and even deny anything that doesn't fit in with the core belief. Mark Twain, it's easier to fool people than to convince them they have been fooled. Why? Because they don't understandably want to realize they've been fooled, but it's a wonderful thing to realize you've been fooled. It's a great gift, because from that point you will not be fooled any longer. It's a wonderful gift. This is another fundamental aspect of the bamboozle. It's called Stockholm Syndrome, a psychological phenomenon in which hostages express empathy and have positive feelings towards their captors, sometimes to the point of defending them. And this scene from the first Matrix movie captured the Stockholm Syndrome so perfectly. You have to understand, most of these people are not ready to be unplugged, and many of them are so inert, so hopelessly dependent on the system, that they will fight to protect it. And this great man, Giordano Bruno, it is proof of a base and low mind for one to wish to think with the masses or the majority, merely because the majority is the majority. Truth does not change because it is or is not believed by a majority of the people. When you find yourself on the side of the majority, it's time to pause and reflect. Why? Because history shows us that invariably the majority are always following a cul-de-sac or a dead end. Mahatma Gandhi, many people, especially ignorant people, want to punish you for speaking the truth, for being correct, for being you. Never apologize for being correct or being years ahead of your time. If you're right and you know it, speak your mind, speak your mind. Even if you are in a minority of one, the truth is still the truth. Birds born in a cage think flying is an illness. What you've been brought up with is your normal, however bloody mad it may be. What we're looking at is what I call bubble people. Bubble people. They live in a bubble of perception and reject anything outside of that perception. Thus, they stay in the bubble. And so all these institutions are programming beliefs and perceptions in the bubble. And unless you break out of it, they're the only perceptions you ever come across. And this is what they say to you. Look, mate, I live in the real world, me. All right, I've got that real world. Go to work, get married, have children, act normal, go, I am free. That's the real world they're talking about. The real world of human slavery masquerading as freedom. You can ignore reality, but you can't ignore the consequences of ignoring reality. Can you remember who you were before the world told you what you should be? Can any of us remember that? When we're born into a world and from day one we're told who we are, what we should do, what reality is, what we should aspire to, what we should oppose, all of it, just a program. If you sense more, there is more. Yes, it's people get stuck in the mode of thinking. And when we feel something, what does it feel? You can say, well, it feels right. It shouldn't, but it does. This is the true self. This is the program self. We have the power to change anything. We have got into this situation by realizing or not realizing the power we have, by not realizing the true nature of who we are.